How come this girl is gonna give me advice on what to wear on date when she's single? That's a good point. Let me tell you that I always smell good and I always get compliments if I'm going on a date. I just think I'm really bad at committing to a relationship. It takes too much of my time and I can't accept it. You're here to hear about my 5 fragrances that I use to seduce for date. Anyway, super sexy, blah blah blah, let's go! Fragrance I'm gonna present to you today are the one I'm always reaching for when I'm going on a date or for different kind of occasion, but just want to make sure I'm super sexy, super feminine. I'm gonna be smelling super addictive. These are probably fragrances that you already seen a lot on my channel, but these are my favorite for to go on a date. Trust me, you can't go wrong with that. One is my Majestic Jardin. This is by Alexander J. Just to let you know, if you ever want to treat yourself by Alexander J, you've got a discount code in the description box. Majestic Jardin was a big crush from this house. First of all, it's affordable for a niche fragrance, so you won't pay millions and millions to get your beautiful bottle. Second of all, super addictive. It's got a really powdery, nearly smoky undertone, so you make sure that you smell a lot around you, that everybody smell you, that when you enter the room, it's the kind of fragrance everybody is like, wow, we're smelling like that. You know, I had so many compliments with this fragrance, and because of the cherry and this narguilé note, so slightly smoky, you know, mysterious vibe, you smell it, you want to get closer to smelling. And that's the idea, that's what we want. And this is usually perfect for me to go dinner, or when I know that the dinner is gonna be a bit longer, if you see what I mean. It's slightly musky as well, cloudy, powdery. And let me tell you that when you buy something like that, it comes with the full packaging, and it is just so luxurious, so beautiful. I mean, look at that bottle, I mean, come on. All have a little bit of sweetness, and this is usually something that is not new, like men, whatever, that you will ask them, like, what is the best scent, like the sexiest scent for them, they would say, oh, something gourmand or something slightly sweet, which is kind of the same anyway. I don't think I need words to describe this anymore. Everyone will describe this as my signature scent, and it's kind of a little bit, you know, it started to be a little bit my signature scent. This is the fragrance I've advised the most, I think, on my channel. Whenever people ask me, like, what's your go-to sexy scent, I'm like, Scherzo, Miley Harris. First of all, Miley Harris is a niche brand, English, that I really love. They do really qualitative fragrance. First time I smelled this fragrance, it was on a lady when I was working for Chanel. She was from Middle East, and she arrived in the shop, and I was like, what's that smell? It was really overpowering to my nose, and I was like, what's this? So I came to her, I said, look, I know I work for Chanel, I shouldn't tell you that, but I said, what is your fragrance? And she told me, this is this, and she said, you have a job just in front of, and I looked at her, I was like, it's divine. It's like, you enter in a room, everybody sees you. Very sweet, you have a lot of sweetness, a lot of juicy fruitiness, the juice of the fruit are really present, and obviously, a woody, a slightly oriental background. Best of Miley Harris is the best one, sorry. It's just incredible how it's intense, how it's long lasting on my skin, and how much compliment I got with this. So whenever I'm not too sure and I'm having a date that probably it's a second, third date or something like that, or you know, maybe there's gonna be some this is what I'm gonna get. Yeah. If it's breaking, I'm dying. Number 3, I don't get presentation with this, is Vive la Juicy Gold Couture. I have to say, when I bought that, I think it was 2 years ago, because of Jeremy Fragrance. He was like, this is the most sexiest scent ever, blah blah blah, it's so sexy, so sexy. Okay, well, it's cheap, let me blend by it, because if he says that he's sexy, let me just get it. Yes, yes, I understand why he said that. All of the male would say, okay, a gourmand fragrance is super sexy. This smells a lot like caramel, and very, very, very sweet. But a sweetness that is not luxurious. Voilà, let's be real. You know, like all my fragrances that I present to you are much more luxurious than that. Like it's got deepness, contrast. This doesn't have much contrast, you know. It's just sweet and smell like caramel. Voilà. So many male reviewers keep recommending this fragrance, say this is the sexiest I smell on a woman. And I'm like, how come? This is sold to me. Like, if you keep saying that, well, of course I'm gonna do it. Like, even if it's not my favorite to wear, if I'm going on a date and you tell me this is like a attractive man, like from really far away, I'm like, okay, well, yeah, like, I'm sorry, I'm gonna wear it. I do personally enjoy myself to wear it when I'm going to bed. I feel it's really relaxing and cocooning, and you know, I don't feel I'm wasting my money when I do that. I started to wearing more during dates. So, you know, if I'm going out with a guy, especially more this one, I would say during daytime or when I'm not going to a very classy thing, because I don't think this is the classiest smell that you can smell. Definitely not. No, it's not trashy, but you know, it's... Usually to elevate that smell, to make it a bit more luxurious, I would have a roll-on, a oud roll-on or a vanilla lac roll-on. Good example are Saint Salim one. If you don't know Saint Salim, I've got plenty of videos about Saint Salim. But I highly recommend you to have a roll-on and oud, and you spray everywhere the fragrance. It gives a slightly luxurious tone to your fragrance, and you make sure you get you compensate the cheaper touch. Like, I remember I've tried like few times, like on a daytime date or stuff like that, and everyone told me I smelled really nice, and I was just like, yes. You're not the most exceptional one, but you do work. I think it's more loved by men than women. Women hate it, like this, but the men, they love it. Next one is my designer fragrance. I think this is, for me, the first date one. The one that you can see before, I would say probably it's when I know a little bit more the fragrance and I know I can show off a bit more my crazy personality. You go in on the first date, you don't really know the person, you don't know what they taste, you don't know what they prefer. Maybe they prefer a very light fragrance, or maybe they like it very much intense. So that's why I'd say go for a designer that it smells slightly sweet, a bit intense, but not too much. You know that you can wear that every day because you don't know that person. And that's the same for men. You don't know the person you're seeing. So let's go. Okay, chill. Chill out. Let me get something that is going everywhere. Prada La Femme Intense usually works the best for me. Classy. It smells slightly sweeter, of course. It's a lot of white floral, probably like tuberose. So very creamy. When you add flowers to a woman's scent, first of all, you smell very feminine, but it smells quite classy to mix sweetness and this yellow tone floral. So it's a lot of bouquet of floral, but quite creamy floral, intense. I can recommend other scents that I know are working a lot. For example, as a designer, I would go for this. I would go for Mont Guerlain. This is not my favorite, that's why I'm not adding in there, but I heard so many men saying they love it on a woman. La Coco Mademoiselle, intense one, you know, things like that. Coco Noir from Chanel, you know, things like that. Like Dior Addict, the vanilla one, great as well, you know, for that kind of occasion. So yeah, there's many that you can try, but I would say the first date, remember, you need to go soft. If you arrive with your scherzo with oud and fruitiness in his face, and maybe he doesn't like that, maybe he's like, yeah, no, I prefer like a more discreet girl. What the hell? Like, the guy, I'm telling you already, is not for me. Oh, anyway, sorry. And the last one, Rolling in Love by Kilian. Easy to wear. I had like many guys like saying that it's kind of a smell that for them are super addictive. It's got that almondy touch as well, this milky note and this creamy milky white tone is just super attractive for them. And I know some reviewers that are like, oh my god, like whenever I smell it, I want to, you know, voila. Something I would wear in the bedroom. It's very intimistic, so it's not the crazy projection, you know, it's more close to the skin, so it's very sensual. It's the most sensual of all of them. Sexy without being dirty, you know, really beautiful lingerie with that. I see passionate relationship with that. I see passionate cuddles and stuff like that. This is what I'm smelling when I'm smelling this fragrance, but keep it classy. Because guys, this is my 5. Let me know, ladies, what are yours in the description. Just wanted to give you an update as I'm here. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel, leave a little like and activate the little bell for receive the notification. Now this is done. Lots of change in my life at the moment. So I'm glad and super happy to tell you that in a few weeks, I'll be much more active on social media. And I will be consecrating all my time to this and to a new project as well, link to that channel and link also to fragrances. that I will be able to share with you probably in a month or two. A lot of work for me to do. But I just want to tell you that I decided to focus myself on this because this year I didn't do not lots of video. I didn't spend time on my social. I didn't have time. I was obviously sick, you know, and things like that. But I'm glad to tell you that I took the decision now to do what I love, which is fragrances, talk about fragrances, share with you stuff, doing videos and things like that. So I'm happy to tell you that I'm going to do what I love in just a few months now. It's going to be a tough decision for me, really tough, but I'm super excited and I think I needed to do that. I will tell you more obviously in the weeks coming, but yeah, it's really exciting. So voilà, have a lovely, lovely day and I will see you very soon. Bye now!